Here we are, gang, Aquarium du Quebec. Go check it out. See how it's going. We're doing some video for YouTube. And I'm going to go this way. I'm not going to go up that ramp. But you see the wheelchair parking right there? Get in right here.
Jellyfish encounter.
Look how dark these are.
I know. Go ahead. This is the spotted lagoon jelly.
bellies. And then these over here all have smaller bellies.
Some brakes. Put the foot down for the brake.
Et une des différences entre les phoques et les otaries, en fait, on a deux principales là, qu'on voit facilement. Ça va être principalement les oreilles. Les phoques vont avoir des oreilles internes, c'est juste le petit trou derrière les yeux en diagonale. Tandis que les otaries, eux, c'est des oreilles externes. Ils ont vraiment un petit pavillon externe comme nous, en fait. Et l'autre différence entre phoques et otaries, ça va être les pattes avant, donc les nageoires avant. Les phoques, vous remarquez, là, ils ont vraiment juste des petites pattes avant. Donc, quand ils se déplacent... Donc, quand les phoques se déplacent, ils vont se donner plus des petites poussées sur les pattes avant, puis bondir un peu sur leur ventre. Tandis que les otaries, eux, vont vraiment... avoir des très longues nageoires avant, très longues pattes avant, pour littéralement marcher.
Okay, we're gonna go see the walrus. And stairs leading up. However, there's, oh dear, there is a ramp right here, steep ramp, that I'm gonna go up. At least there's a ramp.
Non. Donc, ça, c'était vraiment une bonne nouvelle, en fait, pour tout le monde. Ça veut dire, en fait, que la gestation des femelles, c'est super bien passé, sans problème, sans stress, jusqu'à la même bas. Donc, ça, c'est bien déroulé.
Try to get these walruses.
Il y en a
là.
Côté gros, côté gros chambre.
There's three in here? Oh, there is, over there.
La vitesse physiquement pèse en ce moment autour des 450 kg environ. Balzac autour des 850. Et on va avoir Boris qui vient d'être pesé aujourd'hui. Pour, en fait,
huge.
Son poids maintenant, c'est 1313 kg.
Est-ce que
c'est
des mâles? Non,
il y a deux femelles à un mâle.
Mais il ne peut pas se reproduire.
Oui. Il y a eu des bébés.
And then they go back. Oh, and there's the other one. Whoa.
Aiden, come here.
Alright, we saw all three now. Let's go.
And we're up at the polar bears.
Oh, yeah, that one.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
outside. Poor fella. Jeez. This is the hill. You have to wheel up to get to the polar bear enclosure. I'm at halfway mark. And it goes up, up, and up for more. So halfway, let's keep going. So we can go in here, see another part of the enclosure, the polar bear. But there's two polar bears here, and we've only been able to see one. We've seen that other one, he's kind of sitting in his cage, in the caged area. Nobody home today. All right, let's keep going. That was a mega hill to push up. It's a good little workout. If you need to do chair skills, come to the Aquarium du Quebec, or Quebec du Aquarium. I can't, I don't know which way it goes. Upper view of the seals. What's in here?
Elevator.
Are we going up or down? Up. Elevator. Up. Gonna touch. Jellyfish.
Thank you.
big fish tank. I don't know how deep that is. Oh, do I? Oh, I see it there. Yeah, I see the tunnel. Very cool. So I gotta go down. So if you see the tunnel right there, I'm gonna go down and I'm gonna wheel through the fish tank. You curious fellow. Look at you. Type of shark. I can wheel faster than you. How tiny he is. We're going in the ocean, in the tunnel.
Les sébastes, c'est des poissons assez diversifiés, très répandus sur la planète. On peut en retrouver jusqu'à 70 des espèces seulement dans l'océan Pacifique. C'est des poissons de profondeur, donc c'est pas étonnant qu'on va surtout les retrouver ici même dans le tunnel, beaucoup plus qu'en surface. Si vous êtes déjà passé par l'étage supérieur, vous êtes peut-être rencontré quelques poissons, par exemple les barres rayées. Donc c'est des grands poissons rayés qui vont justement se déplacer souvent en groupe, en fait, ils sont moins actifs, comme les sébastes ici. Remarquez en plus les sébastes, c'est pas des poissons de nature timide, donc ils vont souvent se cacher pour justement entre les pierres. Et on a de nombreux prédateurs en plus naturellement, dont les phoques par exemple. Donc ils vont entrer dans la catégorie des invertébrés, donc les animaux qui n'ont pas de colonne vertébrale et de vertèbres. Et ici justement, on va pouvoir pointer les étoiles de mer. Un peu partout, mais qui vont surtout rester sur le sol, parce que c'est surtout un animal qui va ramper avec ses nombreuses.
Okay, now we're gonna go over this wooden bridge to the other part of the park. Ooh. Bit of a drop off here. Gonna pop a wheelie. Get off that rock and get on the crushed rock. Can I get through here? Sure can. A little bit of off-roading. Whoa, get away from me, bumblebee. There we go. No, not really. I guess I could have went around this way instead of cutting across pond, but that's alright, it's all good. Let's go. Yeah, I'm gonna try it. Not likely. No thanks. Pass. Okay, so after that massive hill climb, pond crossing, you can come up to the upper part of the park where you have some barbecue, seating area to eat, play area, park for the kids. That's it. Not much happening up here. Again, we are in the off season now. This nice shot overlooking the majority of the park. The children's park is just behind me, the splash park and the barbecue. Here's a good shot. I'm not sure what that is over there. So take a peek. Just a picnic area to eat. Again, you see the park again on this angle here. You can see it sprawling way, way, way in the yonder. Way in the distance there, that building. That's a polar bear enclosure. The path wraps up then around behind that building. Let's go around that way. This is a good shot of the whole park, pretty much. Ooh, twisties and turnsies. You want to go down? What is this? What are we going to see down here? Oh, it's paths. Lots of paths. Lots of trails to explore. Lots of trails to explore. Let's do it. Let's do it. Ooh. Tilt up there. It's steep. I got two hands on my wheel.
Yeah,
yeah, that's the door. I said you can come out. Who's that? Who's that?
Go this way and then go all the way around and go back up.
Who are you? The red button. Look at this steep. Steep. So I'm going to have to do a two-wheelie on the way down because it's so steep. Okay, see you do this, Danny. You have a time limit. You have 5 seconds hit across. Go. One. Two. It's joking. No time limit. Take your time. Oh, I missed the fall. Try it, Max. Oh, so you chickened out. You can do it. Go across. Oh, we got another chicken. I'm not gonna try that. Yeah. All right, I'm just letting her go. No hands, look, Ma. Oh, there we go.
What?
I said no hands. There we go. I had to stop my foot. I'm gonna do that up there. Look. Wait, Danny. Wait. Wait, Danica. Wait. Watch your mom.
Oh. I don't think you're gonna be able to do it, Mom. I can't go any further. Me neither.
My minutes will
end. I jumped off. I didn't fall. I jumped off.
See, Mom's gonna put you guys to shame here. She gets across. Nope, there it goes.
Oh. I couldn't go across.
I know, you probably could did it.
Is that I was wiggling around.
Pretty agile. Wait, Danica, wait. Danica, wait, wait. Well, she did it. Okay, Danny, it's your turn. You're up. Danica, you're up. Yeah, it's pretty easy. If I had to do that, I could do it.
High? I had to do one like this up high.
Now we're at the Arctic Fox enclosure. There's a little guy there, but we won't see him today. You will see him out today. He's hiding. Somewhere's, yeah, there's some toys in there. Yeah, we won't see him. Okay, folks, that's, that wraps up our day here at Aquarium du Quebec. It's a nice little place. It's not a huge park. I mean, you can get it done in a couple hours. Accessibility-wise, it's got a lot of the stone walkway here. Some of it needs to be repaired for sure in the earlier parts of the park, but you can see they've been doing renovations throughout. It's smoother, but it's very, very hilly. So be prepared for that. It's very hilly. The bathrooms, I've only been into a couple bathrooms, and they're adequate enough for a wheelchair my size, maybe a little bit bigger. Before power chair or scooter, no, not at all. But that's not saying they're not here. I just never came across them, and I didn't have the time to go in all the bathrooms. But other than that, it's fairly accessible. I mean, I would recommend it, but just be prepared for the hills. There's a lot of hills. The pathways go up and down and up. And, yeah, but anyways, all in all, it's a good day. So, all right, take care, and stay tuned for our next adventure. Keep rolling.